According to a new report from the Washington Post, right-wing provocateur Laura Loomer has been officially kicked out of Donald Trump's entourage, right? That little brief, whatever the hell it was, is now coming to a timely end in about 1.5 Scaramuccis, I guess we could call it. But Laura Loomer, as the Washington Post reports, has been informed that she is no longer going to be traveling with Donald Trump. You're not going to be hopping on that private jet. You're not going anywhere with the guy. And the Washington Post went even further and said that sources inside the Trump campaign say that Donald Trump had privately referred to Loomer as crazy. Now, this, of course, is after Donald Trump had said publicly that, hey, she's not involved with the campaign, but she is a free spirit and she's a great supporter. You know, after the controversy erupted when just about every Republican in Washington, D.C. told him, get away from her. She is toxic. Even Marjorie Taylor Greene warned Trump that she is toxic. And that's saying something. When the toxic Avenger herself comes out and says somebody else is toxic, you probably need to listen. But the report goes on to say that Donald Trump had received phone calls from his friends and allies and donors telling him that he's got to get rid of Loomer, so they did. Now, Laura Loomer, of course, is not taking this news very well at all. In fact, she's furious. But she's not furious at Donald Trump, right? She's not mad at the people that actually kicked her out. No, she is directing her ire directly at all those mean, evil Republicans who told Donald Trump to kick her out. Right? The people who didn't make the decision are the ones that she is blasting. So here's a couple of her posts from social media blasting the entire Republican Party. First one was, what does the Republican Party do for me? They have never done anything for me. I do everything for myself. Didn't you run for office as a Republican? So, I mean, technically they did do something for you by allowing you to even be a part of their party and run on their ticket and their platform. So, while I agree that the Republican Party has not done anything for anybody in this country unless you're a millionaire or a billionaire, they literally have done stuff for you by letting you even use their name. So, the one point you made that could have been right is still technically wrong, because you personally have received benefit from the Republican Party. So, oops, you almost made a good point. And then in another one, she said, if Republicans keep the House and take back the Senate, it won't be because they deserve it. It will only be because they rode the coattails of Donald Trump. Not a single Republican is happy with the GOP. They have done nothing over the last 4 years, if we are being honest. Okay, now that one, I give it to you. Not the Trump coattails thing. Like, if Republicans win the Senate and win the House, it's not going to be on the coattails of Trump. It will be in spite of Trump. But the second half of it, you are right about. The Republican Party has done nothing for anyone in the last 4 years. In fact, they've done nothing for anyone in the last 8 years, or the last 16 years, or 20 years, or 30, or 40, or 45. Jesus, you actually have to go back decades to find the last time the Republican Party did anything to benefit anyone other than the wealthy elite. That's how far back you'd have to go, Laura. You almost had it, right? 4 years, multiply that by 10 or 11 or 12. And then it's a correct statement. So I agree that the Republican Party has done nothing for the last 4 years, but you have to go back decades beyond that to find the last time they did anything for anyone who wasn't already wealthy. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.